We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender.
Hi everyone and welcome. Yes, we are here with a brand new build. It is build a model of the Spitfire Mkla. So this is the model that we're going to be doing. Once again, this was a test run a couple of months back and it has now been made into full production. So straight away, I really love how they've got the instructions at the front of the manual. You've got some literature here about the model and a little article down there as well, which is brilliant. So these are the parts that we're going to be doing, and we've got some really nice parts about the history of the plane as well. So just pass that all the way through like so. That's quite a lovely photo, I quite like that. I'll just show the magazine. I am actually phasing out showing the magazine because if you're getting this model, you're going to see it for yourself anyway. So I'm going to be phasing this out, the magazine. Then coming up on the, I believe it's the 26th of February or the 25th, we do actually get issue 2. And then I think it's weekly after that. So the next one is fortnightly. In a fortnight's time. And as you can see here, it does say every week at your newsagent. So from after issue 2, it will go to weekly. They do this with every model, and if you want to subscribe to it, www.spitfiremodel.com. So that's going to be quite an interesting one because it's a motor. So let's get this sorted out. Let's get the instructions up, and these are the parts that we've got. So we've got it in this gorgeous sort of plastic. This plastic was in another part of plastic, and then I just cut it out to make it easier to open on camera, and then you've got this part here. So let's just pop that down for the minute. This looks absolutely brilliant. Wow, that is really heavy. That is metal. These are metal, so this is absolutely brilliant. This part here is plastic. So that's really, really cool how that's metal. I suppose if it's going to be spinning, you don't want it plastic. This is metal as well, so that's quite heavy as well. You've got some packer screws here. For some reason, they're not labelling their screws on this one. Hachette normally label their screws, but on this occasion, they haven't. You've got these two parts, which are plastic, and then you've got some cogs here. So these are the mechanisms that will make the propellers spin. So let's pop that all over to one side. You won't need this. Always check your packaging in case you've got any small bits, and then that can go in my trash kit ball bin. So the first part, what we're going to do is we're going to number the parts at the moment. So these parts here are 1-01, which looks like that. The next parts that we've got is this part here, which is 1-02. And 1-02 is the spinner nose. The 1-01 are the spinner blades. Next part to me is 103 and 104, or 104 and 103, and they're propeller mount with recessed parts. We've then got a pack of 108 screws, and they're 2.3 times 6mm screws, so that looks like that. This part here is 105, and that's the assembly template. And then obviously these sections here, 106 times 3, are the propeller cog, and then you've got the central cog, which is 107, which looks like that. So let's get this sorted out. So the first thing it wants us to do is to take the propeller, which is this part here, and what's going to happen is we're going to face it up so that these lip parts here are bare. And what we're going to do is we're going to have this section here, which is the 103. They're both similar, they both look the same, so it doesn't really matter too much what you use. And this one's going to fit into this little recess that we've got here. So you're going to pop that in, making sure that these all fit up the same. You have got like a little lip section there, but I'm not too, I don't think that makes much of a difference. So let's just check the other side as well. Yeah, this one doesn't have a lip, so I'm assuming it's the one that, because I just need to check that one's got a lip. I'm assuming that that one goes on the top, so we'll pop that there. The next up, what we're going to do is to ensure that the mount fits snugly in the recess, in which it does. So the part after that, we're going to move on to the cog section now. So the central cog is this part here, and that's going to fit into this little rounded part here. You've got like a, what you need to do is face that this little circle part faces over the top like that, and that sits in there really snug like so. The next part, what we're going to do is we're going to get the one of the propellers, and what's going to happen is you've both got like these little lip parts here. So what's going to happen is you're going to get a cog and you're going to get this through here. You've got this little lip key notch and that fits onto this key notch here. So what you've got to do is feed it through so that it fits onto that little key notch. Can you see it there? Like so. And obviously it doesn't really matter which angle you pull it in because they're all going to fit into there, and that, my friends, is going to fit into there like so. Now you can actually pull it like that if you wanted it like that. That's probably the best way to do it because they've got here that the angle part is facing inwards. So yeah, we need to do this another three times, so we'll just do that like so. So let's pop that there. We're just going to move that round like so, like this, and that's going to fit into this section here like so. The next part, obviously, what we're going to do is just put the third one in now. Very similar, very simple to do, and I'm really loving that these are metal. So yeah, so that's popped on there, which is absolutely fantastic. So yeah, you sort of get the idea that that's how it's going to go. It's quite big, so this is really, really interesting. So once we've done that, the next part is to assemble this top part here, and this has got a pin, like a little pin section at the top. Very important that this pin, they've got it facing sort of this way, so whether it goes like that, but they've sort of, it's sort of like off center going down to that one there. So that's fine. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab a screw, and this is a 2.3 × 6mm screw. So you may wanna get like a sticker or something and write down that it's a 2.3 screw. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna drive that screw into this center hole here. So what we're gonna do is we're going to pop that into the center like that, and that's just going to screw into there, which looks absolutely perfect. This screw is going in absolutely fantastic, and it's really, really lovely. You don't want to over tighten it because this is plastic, so you could accidentally break it, but as soon as you feel that biting point, like so, and that's how it is. That, my friends, is issue number one done, and look at that. That is absolutely fantastic. I really, really like that. So that is gonna be something, whoa, okay, so that comes off. That's what's gonna happen, is it's gonna go like that, which is gonna look really, really cool. So absolutely fantastic. Now you've gotta be, careful here, because these are fitted in, it says that the spinner nose is fitted in a future issue. So obviously that's going to come away for the minute, because what will happen is you'll have something that looks like this. I'm assuming that this will fit over the top like that, and where you've got this back hole here, you're going to screw this into something. But as I said, it's not telling you to do that at the moment, but you know what I'm like. I like to have a little play with it. So there we go. That is issue number one of Build the Spitfire. Issue number two should be with me on the 26th. I'm hoping it's going to be in the newsagents. I'm not opening a folder with this because I really want to see if I can grab it in the shops each week. If I can, then I will. If not, we'll have to figure something out. But issue two should be with me on the 26th. And again, after the 26th, it will be weekly. The first issue is always released. Then it goes to a 2-week gap, and then it's back to weekly. But overall, let me know what you think in the video below, in the comments box below. And yeah, I think that is absolutely fantastic. I mean, it's just a brilliant, brilliant piece. I can see a lot of people having a lot of enjoyment out of this build. So yeah, really, really good. And again, although it's vehicles, it's nice to have something different, which is not cars. Everything is car building. So it's nice to do a plane for a change. And that's great about Hachette, because you've got planes, you've got boats, you've got ships, you've got buses. Absolutely brilliant. So take care, guys, and I'll see you very soon for another of the Spitfire, hopefully next week. If it's not up next week, then you definitely know that I haven't been able to get that copy. Thank you very much. Take care and enjoy your day. Bye-bye.
Necessary alone. At any rate, that is what we are going to try to do. That is the resolve of His Majesty's government, every man of them. That is the will of Parliament and the nation, the British Empire and the French Republic, linked together in their cause and in their need, will defend to the death their native soil, aiding each other like good comrades to the utmost of their strength. We shall go on to the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender.